Hello, Coffee Time friends. How y'all doing? It's me, John, and Mama, here with Coffee Time. If you aren't following our page on Facebook, head on over there. Like us, follow us, and share us. Do the things y'all do so well. We are having one of my favorite things tonight, soup beans and cornbread. Mama looked the beans and separated them out, cleaned them, make sure that all those little rocks and little pieces of dirt was taken out of them. And she rinsed the beans, and she took the beans, and she cooked them. How many hours, Mama?
I put them out around 1:30 or 2 o'clock so that they cooked.
All this time. She put them on top of the stove the old-fashioned way in a big old kettle. I know we call a kettle buller or something like y'all call a pot.
Pan.
Okay. We call them all kettles. Little kettle, big kettle, it don't matter to us. And then we have what we call the tea kettle. I know y'all say kettle is for tea, John. Not here. Not in the south. Not in our part of the woods. This is just smoked sausage. Let's head on down here to the cutting board. So we're having smoked sausage and kraut. Some people have the wieners. We do too. But tonight, we didn't have wieners. We had smoked sausage. So that's what we're having. We've had it this way on purpose before. It's delicious. Absolutely delicious. So this is what we're having. Bratwurst and kraut with our delicious soup beans, homemade, cooked today. We like our soupy, so Mama puts plenty of water in there. And it's going to be delicious. I can't wait. You remember when they used to have kraut wings at school and all the kids would just eat the wings out of it and throw the kraut away? I remember doing that as a kid.
I remember doing it too. A lot.
Delicious. All right, Mama. There we go. That was just three brats.
That's enough.
Three smoked sauces. That'd be plenty for us. Look at that. That's the little brats. If you want to do that with stir fry, it's just as good. Look here. This is some of Mama's home canned beet pickles. And those are beets that you pickle with pickle seasoning. They don't look as purple as usual, Mama. Why is that?
I think it's a little bigger, or I cooked them a little longer.
You cooked them a little longer. Can't wait to eat those with soup beans, and we'll get some chow chow out. I've got all kinds of chow chows. Every time I see a jar of chow chow, I buy it. Then Mama makes homemade chow chow, corn chow chow, regular chow chow. What's it called?
Squash relish.
I never call it anything but chow chow. And, I need to open these krauts, don't I? This is our brand, Clover Valley. This, I guess, came from the Gentril, didn't it?
Yeah.
Dollar Gentril. We have a Dollar Gentril here in downtown. I know everybody's got one. Somebody's got 4 or 5. They put those things everywhere. Thank goodness we got one, though. One thing about Jellico, we're appreciative of anything we get. If you want to be appreciated, come here and open us up a business, and we'll appreciate you. We do have a coffee shop now. I've not got a chance to get down there. Because of the hours they're open. I'm going to get down there, though, and check it out. Might take y'all with us. Might go live there if they let me. I always ask before I do go live. Huh? That's a salad you dropped, Mama. Now, this is the canned kraut. I like jarred kraut for certain things, but for cooking, we usually just use canned kraut. You can tell it's not bubbling, it's not old or anything. It's kraut. It's good. I like the white jarred kraut for sandwiches and eating on hot dogs and stuff like that. You can hear those, I started saying kielbasas, those brats browning over there. Let's look at Mama, see what she's doing.
No, don't look at Mama, I'm in a mess.
What are you doing, Mama?
I was hunting for another jar of that, and I've not found it.
That what?
Relish.
Oh, well, just open up some. I bought some store-bought. We've got some of yours in there. It's all good. Good for you. You know, actually, kraut, fermented, pickled stuff is very good for you. I was in my office today. I actually accused them of trying to poison me. But two of the girls that work there, ladies, young ladies, said, have you ever tried pickles and Kool-Aid? Have you? Well, evidently, the recipe is a jar of dill pickles. I think it's one pack of your favorite Kool-Aid and a half cup of sugar. And you let it sit for 5 days. I had not heard. I had heard of it, but I had never tried it. Well, you know, I thought we were just talking. In a minute, she brought me a great pickle. See, I knew it was poison. She's got my tongue missing. A grape pickle. It's hard to say that unless you practice it. So she brought me a grape pickle in there that had been, and she bought this one. She didn't make this one homemade. This was store-bought. I'm going to tell y'all, it's not as bad as you think. It's got a different little flavor to it. But it was purple pickle. And one of them said the Hawaiian punch made the best Kool-Aid pickles. Have y'all ever heard of such? Yes, and it's absolutely nasty. Do you ever go to the little juice scoop? I have, yes.
Right here.
Babe, we did go to
things you can pour your kraut in.
See how brown and beautiful they are? You got that set flat on the counter?
No, it's on the head. That's had a lot of kraut in it.
Yeah. It was packed tight.
Oh, I can smell that kraut. It's getting hot already.
Clean can coming back. Yes, we do have the little juice scoop down there. We've got pizza spot, little juice scoop. We've got the coffee shop now. You can get food at all those places. It's wonderful. Oh, let's go back. Go up. I've never seen any other than cherry. You're talking about the pickles. Well, I hadn't seen any of them. I'd heard about it. But cherry would be good. This was grape. So the pickle looked blue, because green, purple, make it look blue. She said, here. I said, are you trying to poison me? She said, no. I said, that's what somebody who would be trying to poison me would say. Anyway, it was okay. I didn't like, it was not something I would eat with food or anything. But they're doing all kinds of things with pickles. Pickles are the rage now. They're wrapping them in Jolly Ranchers and putting sugar on them and dipping them in chocolate. And they are. I'm not done any of those things. It's a novelty little thing that they claim that they can't let them set long enough because they eat them before the 5 days is up. That's how good they are. So, I don't know. If I try another kind, I'll let you know it too. I like new things. I like different things. Then I like just plain old things. I like old-timey things like soup beans or pinto beans. And this is Mama's relish right here. Look at that. Y'all made this with us back last fall for last. Y'all made this with us on September 27th, 2021. Fall for last. September 27th, 2021. That's when we made this. and it's still good. Can you imagine you make something 2 years ago and it's still delicious? Well, this will be absolutely delicious. And I love it with my pinto beans. Squash relish. That's what it is. I call it chow chow. Because what I don't know, I've always remember when I was a kid, you had chow chow. And I'd say, Mama, say you want some chow chow? And I said, ew, no. And then when I got older, I don't know if I accidentally tasted it, if I tasted it because it smelled good. But then I love chow chow. And my daddy would eat chow chow on peanut butter sandwiches. Pickles with pintos is good. Now, that I have tried, pickle relish in pintos. Do you have recipe for relish? Lana, Mama? Yeah, Lana, we have it because we made it. I don't know if Mama's got a recipe. Did you make this up, Mama?
It's from squash pickles instead of...
You can't. Slots. Can y'all hear Mama?
They're from my squash pickle recipe. Instead of slicing my squash and peppers and everything, I chopped them up real fine, or you did.
We put these in the supersonic chopper.
Yeah.
But she didn't give you the recipe, did she? What's the recipe, Mama?
It's in the... It's in the cookbook.
She thinks everything's in the cookbook. I didn't know. I don't think the squash pickles are in the cookbook.
They're in there from Sherry Wilson in honor of Don Burgess.
Are they?
I don't think they are.
Well, she knows a lot of details about this one. Let's look it up. Well, I guess it would be this and that.
Yeah, pickles.
Squash pickles on page 56. You who have a cookbook. Well, I bet.
What does it say?
It says, given to Cherry Wilson by Don Davis, my daddy, on 7/18/10. Squash pickles. It's got almost 2 pages. It goes to the top of the next one. Let me read you the recipe. I'll tell you what I'll do. Hold on just a second. This will take some movements. Rotate. So here it is. You can screenshot that part. The very bottom, squash pickles. Screenshot. And then you see continued on the top of this page right here. And screenshot that top. And there you can have tomato sauce, meat. But June Moses, too. You can screenshot. That top is the finishing part of the squash pickles. Okay. And you can, that's the pickles where you slice them. But you can put it through your food processor or your supersonic chopper and you can get that as well. So it's squash pickles. It's 8 cups of squash sliced. This is straight neck or crooked neck squash. Okay. 1 cup of green pepper chopped, and that's just bell pepper. 1 cup of red pepper chopped. And this is just sweet red pepper, right?
It's just the... Yeah, bell peppers.
4 medium onions. This is just a yellow onion or a white onion. 4 medium cut into rings. 3/4 teaspoons of mustard seeds. 3/4 teaspoons celery seeds. 2 1/4 cups sugar, 1 1/2 cups white vinegar. Mix first three ingredients, the squash, the peppers, green and red. And let it set for an hour. Bring the rest of the ingredients to a rapid boil. Add squash mixture to the boiling mixture. Okay, that's your slices of squash, I thought.
Now with your vinegar and sugar, you bring your vinegar and sugar and stuff to a boil, and then you pour it over your pickles.
Mm-hmm. And bring to a rapid boil again, makes 4 pints. Mm-hmm. So it says, mix the first three ingredients and let it set for 1 hour. The first three ingredients is 8 cups of squash, 1 cup of green pepper, 1 cup of red pepper. So you mix that together and let it set for an hour. And then you bring the rest of the ingredients, which is your 4 medium onions cut into rings, 3/4 teaspoons of mustard seeds, 3/4 teaspoons of celery seeds, 2 1/4 cups of sugar, and 1 1/2 cups of white vinegar. You bring that, the rest of the ingredients, to a rapid boil. And then add your squash and your peppers to that and bring it to a rapid boil again. And then it makes 4 pints. If you have a cookbook, it's at the bottom of the page on page 56. And it was given by our friend Cherry Wilson, and it was in memory of my dad. And that's it.
He loved them. He gave the recipe
out. He loved them and gave it to everybody. He gave them to everybody.
I'm out of napkin. You got a napkin?
I have one. Well, it's battered and bruised and been through it, but I can use it.
Oh, wow.
I'll smooth it back out so it'll look like something done embarrassing in front of your friends.
Well, that's a good
thing to have. Put it underneath the plate right where it goes. Put my fork right there where it goes.
Get your bread.
Now, this is our bread that we had last night, so it's not a whole pile.
We're not wasting.
We ain't wasting. And I'm going to put me some beans right in here, Mom.
I'll get you some beans.
I'm going to let y'all see them there, beans. Hold on a second. Look how soupy and delicious.
They are soupy.
They are delicious.
You've tasted them
out here. I tasted what you gave me a while ago.
I'll make you be my taste. If they don't taste good, then you can.
I want soup. That's
I'm
enough beans.
I'm getting you some.
Enough beans. Let's go soupy.
I'm getting some soup.
When I say soup beans, I mean soup beans. Y'all hold up there.
There you go.
Thank you, Mama. And I want some crown.
These are real light.
They are lighter, but that's just the bean.
What is it? It
comes from the Save-A-Lot.
Save-A-Lot. I don't know what the brand name is right now.
Sometimes they will be lighter. If you want them thicker, you can pull out some of the beans and mash them up, put them back in there, thicken it up.
Or just let it cook down dry.
When you stir these, they get darker looking. But they're done. That's what counts. You want you some kraut, Mom?
Oh, yeah. I have to have some kraut.
Kraut's good for you. Let's bless it. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful meal. May this pray for the nourishment of our bodies, dear Lord. And dear Lord, we just pray that you'll be with each and every one of them out there, dear Lord, that's had prayer requests and those unspoken prayer requests as well. Lord, put a hedge protection on each and every one of us. Be with our world, dear Lord. Be with our leaders. Be with the leaders all over this world, dear Lord. In your name we pray and ask all these things. In your precious name. Amen.
Amen.
All right, Mama. I'm going to have beets.
I want a beet while you're fishing. I'm going to have.
You want a medium sized beet?
Yeah, I just want one.
I'm going to have beets with an S. Beets.
Now realize what you're saying. Plural beets.
Yep. Next up on one. Kraut and beets Now my chow chow, I'm gonna show you how to eat my chow chow. Someone asked me one time, how do you eat chow chow with soup beans? Well, I'm gonna show you. You take your soup beans, you put your little bit of cornbread. I don't fill mine full. I put my cornbread, I let it right in there like that. And I let it start doing its business. And it'll soak that juice up.
I'm losing my crap.
It'll soak that juice right up. Real delicious like. Now see that? Then I take my chow chow. I'll slide it right down the side right there. And then I'll get my cornbread, my chow chow, a little bit of bean. There's a bite fit for a king. Mmm. And it is tasty. Seeing your chow chow just hang out right there with that piece of cornbread for the next run. Delicious.
I cut your onion up over there too.
Mmm. Purple onion. You want some purple onion, Mama?
No, I better not. This stuff will.
It don't have to be purple.
We didn't have no five days.
We don't have no 5 days left. But it don't have to be purple. But purple is just as good. Any kind of good onion. And sometimes I'll chop it up or, you know, dice it up and put it on top and eat it that way too. How do y'all eat yours? Looks so good, TGI. Yes, Christy, thank goodness it's Friday. Some of y'all have a long weekend. That's good if you're off on Monday. Mm.
Oh, Presidential Day.
Presidents. I call them pinto beans. Linda, we call them pinto beans. We call them soup beans. Either way. Nola says, chow chow recipe. She wrote it up last year when we had it. When we made it. Or whenever we made it, I guess. Mmm. That's the perfect bite, Mama. Mm-hmm. Let's try this kraut. These wonderful brats. Mmm. Delicious.
Your daddy would have enjoyed this stuff real good,
wouldn't he? Oh, yeah. And he would have said, you can't fix nothing to make me any happier than this right here.
Yeah.
Totally. Are you drinking water?
Yeah. You had your coffee, so I didn't ask you.
Mama's drinking water, not Sprite, not Zero, just water. It kind of worries me when she drinks water just voluntarily. I say, something wrong, you feeling bad, you think you need water? No, I just thought I would drink some water. How come you're drinking it tonight? You feel bad?
No, I just thought I'd taste my food better with water.
And this is a revelation?
A revelation.
I mean, it's the first time you thought of that?
No.
You didn't want to taste it good before?
I've drunk water before.
When I make it and put it in a pitcher.
No, I drink water. I drank a bottle of water the
other night. All summer, we keep a pitcher of water. We have water in the refrigerator door, but just that pitcher, glistening. When you take it out and put it on the table, you'll just drink water and it just looks so good. Don't it, Mama?
Oh, yeah.
And you can infuse it, put you some strawberries in it, put kiwi in it, put peaches in it. It's delicious. This is delicious, Mama.
Okay.
Absolute, an A-B day. Absolute beautiful day, absolute beautiful supper. We've had a little bit of air weather today. Let me tell you my story. So I had to travel this morning. So I headed out. on my usual route. Maggie's drinking water. Or Mama's eating soup beans one.
Mm-hmm.
And I couldn't get there from here. There was water over the road. A lot of it. It went up to almost the bottom of a truck. Because I watched the truck go through it. So I turn around and go to another route. Just got started on that route, and the water was over that route. And I had to turn and go another route. I had to take two detours just to get to work. And then, after it had rained all night, I get halfway to this office I'm going to, and it starts peppering the snow. And everything was white. If the sun had been in my eyes, I could have had all the seasons. Spring rain, sunshine, and winter snow all in one trip to work. Welcome to East Tennessee, folks. If you don't like the weather, we'll change it in just a minute.
We've got it all.
Same for me. I live in MD. Oh, your weather's like that too. Cindy, I know, I feel your pain. Yummy, it's a good supper. It is. Hey, Karen. Baby. Juanita. I joined them all. Hey, Robin. Hey, Laura. Y'all are going slow and then you go fast. You got a lot of rain too in Richmond, Mary. We did too, like buckets. It wasn't raining drops, it was raining buckets. And we've had flooding, it's still flooded. Normally, our flooding
subsists. You just come straight home or you have to detour coming home?
Well, I came home the detour I took this morning.
Oh.
What does that mean? Yes, I guess, I don't know. But there was still water over the road some places. It's a real thing, I tell you. Mommy, you got anything else for him tonight?
No,
I'm not. You want to sing your dance?
I'm not eating at the store.
She ain't going to sing or dance. She's eating. Soup beans, perfect for today. It is. Winter here today. Debbie, you getting snow? We get snow. It snowed again later in the day. White again.
I went to the mailbox. It's more like ice than snow. It was a pepper.
No, this was big old flakes. And it was, then we had a little flake and it was just solid. It was like a heavy fog, but it was snow. And the treetops got white. The roofs got white. Cars got white. The roads didn't get white. They're still warm. But we had quite a bit of snow. You are eating a little early tonight. Yeah, we are, because Mama had soup beans ready when I came in the door, and the cornbread was from last night. No prep tonight. All we did was a little bit of kraut and wings. Mama did all the prep before I got here tonight. Beans look so good. Thank you. Your dinner looks delicious. Thank you, Elizabeth. Rain. Pretty much still raining there. I don't know what the weather's going to be. I ain't looked.
Not either.
You've not seen it on TV?
Not
much. Love soup. Barbara, I love soup too. We were talking about that the other night at church. I used to eat soup as a kid. I went to a spell. I didn't want soup of any kind, except tomato soup with grilled cheese dipped in it. I'd still eat that. But any other kind of soup, even chicken noodle when I was sick, count me out. I didn't want no soup. Mom said, you gotta have to eat no soup. And then through my 20s, I didn't really care for soup. I know when I got through my 20s, I started liking soup again.
The old age of
him. In my 20s?
It starts working on you early sometimes.
Well, now, I can't get enough soup. I like all soups. I like vegetable soup, vegetable beef soup, soup of all kinds, broccoli soup. I don't know. It's just like soup, soup, soup. Sometimes I tell Mom, I'm just craving soup. Can we just have soup? She'll say, oh, yeah, that'd be good. So, I don't know. It's just weirdness, but I love soup beans. I love 16 bean soup. Mm, yeah. Love them all. Are you eating pinto beans again? I can hear you.
Oh, I'm slapping them up.
Oh, well. Oh, you know what we're in? And I can't believe this. Mama told me last night. Mm-hmm. We're in the last week of Tupperware. Wednesday's the last. We end Tupperware on the last Wednesday of the month. Wednesday's it, folks. What? Yes, look at your calendar.
It's over.
February's over. March is here. Spring. Pop, it's coming. I saw today. Give me see what I told Mama. I even told you this.
Oh, no.
Guess what I saw today?
No flowers are blooming.
What kind?
March bells.
That's it. The little yellow flower bushes, the forsythias, the March bells. I saw a whole row of them blooming on my way home.
Oh, wow.
That is the sign, folks. That's the flip, the switch. Spring is coming. Easter lilies, daffodils, they'll steer you wrong a little bit. You'll have them in the snow. And I know it snowed today. But when that March bell forsythias bloomed, things are starting to happen. They were all bloomed out, and I thought, tomatoes. First thing when I see them. When I see them, I don't think, oh, look at the pretty yellow flowers. I see them, and my mind goes, tomatoes. It won't be long, because as a kid, I remember our forsythias were bloomed. The bachelor button was a little white button. Baby's breath, you probably call it, would be bloomed, and I'd be standing out there watching my daddy plow the garden, getting ready to plant. And I knew when them yellow bushes bloomed, it was garden time. When the garden count is coming, Mama would be planting some tomatoes. So as a small child, that's my memory, and it's just a trigger. It switches my mind to spring. So I'm declaring it today. It's first March bell.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to check their March bell.
See if it's blooming.
We've got a March bell here for forsythia. I'm going to check it out. See if it's a blooming. Is your forsythia blooming?
Well, is this further south than us?
Mama, it's right up the hill.
Oh, well.
Just right up the road, about 10 miles. Not farther. It's
not
further.
Far enough for it to make a difference.
No, it's time.
It's here.
I've seen cherry trees bloom. Oh, that's another sign, Valerie. When cherry trees, I love the cherry trees. The plants and trees were confused with the weather. Yeah, Dorian, that could be. But it's still the end of February. And it's the end of our Tupperware catalog, too. So go online and look at the catalog. Anything you see in there, grab it. One thing, utensils, I don't know if they'll be the same as they have been on singles. I think they may do those in more
pairs or
yeah. So if you want some single of those, grab them. Everything that's in the catalog could be subject to change. It probably won't, but some of it could. So this is the last before we get a new catalog coming out March with some new products. And it's a big week. I'll post some stuff that's going to be on sale. Get your towels, your dust rags, your dust mops, your eyeglass cleaners. I have one of these at arm's length at everywhere I'm sitting because they are the best glasses cleaner that I have ever had. And they even have a little pair of glasses on them. But I'm going to tell you something. Tupperware's missed the mark on advertising of these. Because they should have a pair of glasses and then right beside of it a little cell phone because they clean my cell phone better than anything I've ever used. The screen is clean, and this is why I clean you all so you can see good. Every night I come up and get you a little, this is it. And these are wonderful. Yeah. I've had several from the eye doctor. I even bought some that's supposed to be better. These are the best. But they clean your TV screen, they'll clean your iPad, they'll clean your telephone, any screen, and we're all screen crazy, your computer screens. These are the best.
I need to clean my iPad right now with one. It's messy.
Well, you probably got one by your chair, Mama.
I have. Got it by my bed.
I keep one of these in my nightstand. And in my line of work, I have several offices I go to. There's one in every office desk drawer right in the front. I'd keep it in the same place. And they're perfect. So get those. Get anything you want out of the catalog because this was last week. I'll post some things.
Is the Easter baskets completely gone?
Easter baskets were last week. They're gone. That was a 1 week sale.
I thought they were showing some more of them.
They may if they had some left.
Check that out.
Mm-hmm. And let's see, any other deals and spills?
They've got the Mickey Mouse
snack stuff. If you're into Mickey Mouse, they got a beautiful Mickey Mouse snack thing on there. But anyhow, this is a Tupperware video. We'll do one of those coming up. So you all have a blessed night.
Oh, yeah.
Enjoy your evening. Enjoy your weekend. It is early.
We've done really well.
Yeah. We'll have it cleaned up before we use the start.
Oh, what a relief.
Thank God it's Friday. Yeah. We have the weekend to look forward to. Y'all do something fun. Be blessed. Do something with the family. Get together tonight. If you just sit around and watch movies or play games or whatever, have some fun. Spend a little quality time.
That's right.
And then go to bed early and get up early in the morning.
Enjoy it.
And drink lots of coffee.
Well, if you go to bed early and drink lots of coffee, a lot of people won't sleep.
You missed it, Mama. Go to bed early. Then go to bed, and I said, then get up early and drink lots of coffee.
Oh, get up early and drink lots of coffee. Now, you do that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I do that.
You do what you preach. I'm glad for certain.
Let me ask y'all a question before we go.
Oh, no.
You alarm setters, do you hit snooze in the morning?
I do. I don't set alarm.
I sure said, Mama. What are you hitting? You don't even set an alarm.
No.
Do y'all hit snooze? So I'm watching the Facebook the other night, and a woman says, she claims to know what she's talking about, that, you know, that it is weird now that she's mentioned it. You know, when you hit snooze and you go into sleep, and you're really sound asleep, when that next alarm goes off, you're like, ugh. But you've been dreaming, so that's a good rapid eye movement, REM sleep. She says that we wake up, we should get up, and not fool with snooze, because when you go back to sleep after being awakened, your body goes into a deep sleep in a REM state, and it takes 70-some minutes for your body to get through that REM state of sleep. Well, we wake it back up, and it messes our rhythm up, and she says it takes up to 4 hours to lose that feeling of tired and groggy. Now, I will tell you this. I have woke up many times at 4 a.m. and feel like jumping through the house and being ready, and then at 5 I wake up and I'm like, oh, I'm so tired. Have y'all done that? Well, she says, and I don't know. I'm not saying she's right. I'm just saying I'm going to give it a little thought and see. Because I will hit snooze sometimes. Most times I'm awake and I get up, but sometimes I'll hit snooze. Maybe the snooze is not good for us. Maybe we need to set our clock 10 minutes later. If you're wanting to get up 10 minutes later and then get up then. I don't know. So there is some thought to be put in that. So I just want to ask y'all, I'll leave you with a question. Y'all can comment below. Do you snooze or not to snooze? That's the question. I didn't snooze this morning. And I feel fine today, but normally I don't snooze, but sometimes I do snooze. And by snooze, I mean hit that button. And it,
wait 10 minutes.
It does a delay for 10 minutes. Y'all probably using your smartphones for your clocks now. I think 99.9% of the people in America don't have an alarm clock anymore. We have our phones. How many of y'all hit that snooze? That's why the snooze alarm is 9 minutes between before you go into REM sleep. Is that right, Donna? Okay. That's good. A woman posted, you know, Holly says a woman posted, you don't care. I don't know what that means. My eyes are my alarm, and I get up on the weekend. I do too. Sure. So you're saying when you see daylight, you get up? Yep. Not. I get up
before daylight.
When the alarm goes off. Robin, I used to get up before my alarm goes off. I don't trust alarms, so I don't know. Yeah, you know, they are hard to trust. Sometimes, don't use snooze. I say more, don't use snooze. Never hit snooze. Good, Robin. Good day for pintos. It is, Teresa. John, I am posting pinto bean recipe. Thank you, Nella. I never have used snooze. Oh, look, you all are not snoozers. A lot of you are not. I try not to snooze. Cindy, good. I don't unless I've gone to bed late and I'm like, the alarm goes, I ain't ready. Can't hit the snooze. But most of the time, I don't snooze. I never have used snooze. Marcia? No, I don't snooze. See, y'all are not snoozers. Clock set 10 minutes after. Yeah, just set your clock a little later. My cell always lets me hit snooze button 23 times.
Damn many times.
I love it.
That'd be me.
Hey, Jackie, I'm retired. I sleep late. Good, Peggy. I used to hit snooze. I'm retired, so now it's useless. Mama cleaned her plate and drank water. Thank you for noticing. She's pretty and looks like Mama, but it must not be. Anita, I hadn't thought about that. Who is this?
That's an imposter.
Yeah, it's her. These are her soup beans anyway. I know that. I snooze three times every day. Well, Dorian, one of them said it's a 9-minute snooze, so you don't go into REM. Me too, Peggy. I think that Peggy was one who's retired. Well, you aren't snoozers either. I always hit snooze, Kelly says. Oh, yes. Use the snooze.
Makes you feel good that you've got 8 or 9 more minutes sleep.
Oh, yes. I use the snooze when I work. Oh, yeah, Patty says. And yeah, it's like you're like, I don't care, that snooze. You're like, you can take my car, I want to snooze, I don't care. Supper looks so good, Susan, it is good. Well, thank y'all for helping me with that question. I'm a snoozer. Tia says she's a snoozer. I like my sleep a little too much, Mary. Lisa, I used to sleep late. When I thought the snooze was one time and turned it off and was late for work, never did it again. Well, Marianne, I guess that would make anybody a little gun-shy. When you, as mom says, I snooze sometimes. That's me. I have done it sometimes. But on the regular, I don't. I'm
at work. I just jumped up and got ready and
went. I don't usually, I set an alarm, but I normally don't go off. Normally, I wake up before it goes off and I turn it off. In fact, it's kind of a little game.
You usually go to the bathroom before it even goes off most of the time.
Yeah. It's kind of like a game with me. I wake up and I'm like, oh, it's not going off. Let me see if I can get it turned off before it goes off. And it's a race. Got it. Because I do wake up very close to the time every morning, number one. Today is my husband's birthday. I've cooked all day. I will be hitting snooze in the morning.
That's right. She deserves it.
April, you tell your husband happy birthday.
She deserves a snooze in the morning.
Made the chocolate covered strawberries today. They were dropped the fork good, Mitch.
They are so good. You deserve a treat every once in a while. Fix you some chocolate cookies.
Guilty, Denise says she snoozes. You don't have to be guilty, Sam. Does Mama drink coffee? Mama drinks coffee
every once in a while in the morning.
She'll drink it a couple of times a week, 3 times a week maybe. If I get up and make coffee, there's a good hot pot of coffee there. When she comes in, it's more tempting than waiting on tea or something. She'll use that big hot pot of coffee and she'll get her some, put some hazelnut and some French vanilla. But on the normal, if there ain't no coffee, she's going to have to wait for it or make it. She just has tea. And what we do is we make y'all sweet tea in a gallon of unsweet now. We don't use any sugar in it. So she just gets it out of the refrigerator, puts it in her cup, and puts it in the microwave, heats it up, and then she adds what she wants or just drinks it with no sugar. She put honey in it or whatever she wants.
When I sick coughing a whole lot, I used a lot with honey and lemon.
Mm-hmm. That was your little treat. Mm-hmm. Well, my cornbread soaked up all the juice.
Uh-oh. We'll have to get you some more juice.
Mama, you got anything you want to tell them?
No.
But we're going to tell y'all good night. Sleep tight. Snooze in the morning if you want to.
Yes.
And don't even set an alarm if you don't have to work. And y'all have a blessed night. Enjoy it. Say good night, Mama.
Good night, Mama. And God bless you and so. Bye-bye.
Bye, y'all.